statement. Got a funny feeling. Bigfoot's gonna be here soon. I was so blind before, I was so unaware. But now I swear I'm seeing Sasquatch over there. And I turned on my radio in the middle of the night, and I heard things I need to know. Now I can see the light, and I also see a ghost. Cause I'm listening to Coast to Coast. Well, you never knew that your baby was a hybrid. But as he grew, you began to see the clue. Now you know the signs, but you learned it from your snoring. Even while you sleep, you've got Marcy watching you.
Sean Radasour, Stephanie Smith, Chris Morris, Ryan Stacy, Tim Banal, George Napanee, and Punted. I'm George Norrie, somewhere out there on Coast to Coast AM. We'll see you on our next edition. Until then, be safe.
Cost refis at a great low rate, and owning did it all in less than 3 weeks. It was easy, no muss, no fuss.
Be like Gary. Call owning at 855-5-OWNING and crush your mortgage payment with today's 30-year fixed refi at 2.625% rated APR with no closing costs. None. Zero. Even if you've refinanced recently, call 855-5-OWNING and let us crush your monthly payment even more. That's 855-5-OWNING or log on to owning.com.
NMLS 2611, licensed by the Department of Financial Protection and Innovation under the California Residential Mortgage Lending Act. Subject to credit approval. Call 823-852-6464 for terms and conditions.
You can crush it too with a 30-year fixed 2.625% rate in APR with absolutely no closing costs.
Portions of the following program will be recorded.
Friends, I'm Dean Sharp, the house whisperer, custom home builder, custom home designer. Hey, it's just about 6 o'clock. You know what that means? For the next 2 hours, I'm going to be here with you as a friendly voice in your morning and your personal guide to turning your ordinary house into an extraordinary home. It's remodels gone right today, and it all gets started in just a couple of minutes. So stay tuned and welcome home.
This is KFI and KOSD HD2 Los Angeles, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. AM 640.
If you didn't like that opinion, keep listening. We've got a few more.
KFI.
KOST HD2.
Los Angeles, Orange County.
Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
The Delta variant gains momentum. I'm Claudette Stefanian, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. 96% of all recent COVID-19 lab samples in LA County are the Delta variant.
Health officials say from July 18th to the 24th, 675 samples were collected, and the 96% lab result is consistent with the rise of the Delta variant nationwide and with CDC estimates. Officials say there are still 4 million residents in LA County that are not yet vaccinated, and the health department says the variant is more efficiently transmitted between people because of its faster replication, higher viral load, and the way it more easily enters the lower respiratory system compared with earlier COVID strains.
The head of the CDC says there will not be a federal mandate requiring people to get the COVID-19 vaccine. Dr. Rochelle Walensky says she understands why people would not want to be required to get the vaccine, but she says it wouldn't be much different from older vaccines that have been required for kids in school or hospital staff. Environmental experts say the heat wave last month was the most extreme summer heat wave ever recorded in North America. The Berkeley Earth nonprofit group says record temperatures across the region were nearly 36 degrees hotter than average for June. Researchers say the high temperatures led to nearly 200 heat-related deaths in the U.S. and nearly 600 deaths in Canada. The federal ban on evictions is set to expire tonight. Lawmakers in the House of Representatives adjourned yesterday without passing any legislation to extend the eviction moratorium. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi says the CDC should have done more to keep the measure from expiring.
Now the CDC is saying more on masks and more on vaccinations and more on other public health advice. You think it was true that they would not be able to extend the moratorium, which is a health issue.
When the CDC set the July 31st expiration date, it said the moratorium wouldn't be extended again. A test of a new battery system Tesla's working was lit.
The battery, which is actually a massive complex the size of a football field, caught fire during an initial test run in Victoria, Australia. Nobody was hurt, but nearby residents had to stay indoors because of toxic smoke. The Tesla Megapack is being built in partnership with French and Australian energy companies. The battery is meant to store energy and prevent blackouts while Victoria moves toward renewable energy sources. The Megapack is scheduled to go online by the end of this year, but the cause of this fire is under investigation. Brian Berman, KFI News.
Baseball is now the official sport of New York. Governor Andrew Cuomo says New York is the birthplace of baseball and the Baseball Hall of Fame is in the state. But not everyone thinks the decision is a home run. Many people say basketball is more popular in New York than baseball is. And with that, let's turn things over to traffic with a look at a crash in Diamond Bar.
It's on the 60 eastbound at Grand Avenue. All lanes are closed due to an overturned vehicle. Traffic is backing up to about Lemon. In West LA, the 405 north of Wilshire, that's an accident that's clear from lane. In Santa Ana, on the 5 south of 17th Street, that's an accident step of 3 left. Lane blocked and stopped to go from the 22. Only the right lane is open at this time. And then Riverside 215 south of University, that's another accident that's clear from lane. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Zachary Tagan.
Brace for a scorcher in some parts of the Southland. We break it down for you next.
Hey everybody, Jay Farner here, CEO of Rocket Mortgage and Rocket Companies. Last year we saw historically low mortgage interest rates. In fact, over 1 million homeowners took advantage of refinancing or buying a new home with Rocket Mortgage. What you may not know is that interest rates are already starting to increase again, and it's likely that trend is only going to continue. Our team of experts is standing by to help you save before rates go up. With an official mortgage review from Rocket Mortgage, you'll see just how much money you could save by making a move right now. Don't look back over these next few weeks and wish that you had taken action. You could save hundreds on your mortgage payments or pay off your home loan earlier than planned. You could even take cash out of your home to pay off high interest debt, complete home repairs, or bulk up on an emergency fund. When you want to secure a low rate, Rocket can. Call 833-8-ROCKET or visit rocketmortgage.com.
Call for cost information and conditions equal housing lender license in all 50 states and NMLSconsumeraccess.org number 33.
Southland weather from KFI. Sunny for today. Highs from the upper 60s to mid-70s at the beaches. Upper 70s and 80s inland. Highs from the 80s and 90s for the valleys. Highs from 82 to 87 in the inland OC. Highs from 94 to 100 in the IE. Lows to drop into the 60s by nightfall. Taking you through temperatures, we are seeing in the Southland in Anaheim at 66, Laguna Beach 60, Diamond Bar 64, and Cerritos 65. We lead local live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Claudette Stefanian.
Custom home builder, custom home designer, here for you live like I am every Saturday morning from 6 to 8 and Sundays from 9 to 11. Why are we here? I'm here to be a mentor for you, a design mentor, because when it comes to transforming your home, design matters most. I'm here to be an advocate for you, to help you figure out what you're doing as you wrestle with construction issues, and, just a friendly voice in your morning. As you take on the noble work of transforming your ordinary house into an extraordinary home. The team is all here. Sam is on the board doing what he does. Misty, the boss, she is going to be standing by to take your calls in just a little bit. That's right. My best buddy in the universe and my partner in all things design, Tina, is here this morning. Hey, we're sharing a mic, so.
Good morning.
Hey, there you go. And Claudette Stefanian is on the news desk. Good morning, Claudette.
Good morning. How are you?
You have way too much energy.
I know. I really think I need to figure this out. It's like too much energy coming at people.
No, it sounds good, but I thought I was kind of lively, and then you're on, and like, no, okay, wake up, Dean, wake up.
And everyone's like, can you please dial it back, please?
No, don't dial it back, no, just keep the bar raised. That's a good thing. Also, Sam the Beagle is in studio with us here. Sam, any comments? No, he's getting his belly rubbed, so no. He's like, no, I have nothing to say. Just continue. Move along. All right, here's what we're doing today. From time to time, we do a kind of a show that I like to call Remodels Gone Right. And what that is I have some folks in the studio with me when we do these shows. Former client or clients, current clients or friends or, you know, whatever that may be. And folks who have gone through a significant remodeling process. Because I think, in addition to talking about it as we do every single week and talking, you know, we talk theory, we talk practical points, I think it's great for you to hear straight from the horse's mouth sometimes what people's experiences are firsthand. And so we do that from time to time. I think, well, on average, maybe a couple of times a year, we'll do a Remodels Gone Right. But today, I built that up way too much. Today, this is going to be our Remodels Gone Right, our very first DIY edition, okay? So what that means is
Not only do I have a couple of folks here with me today who have just completed a significant major remodel, but in their case, they did it themselves with their own four hands. Because there's, you know, two of them, and they're both able-bodied, so there are four hands. So in studio with me today, my very dear friends, Amy Carr and Ben Powell, who have come down. Well, you didn't come all the way down here from Chico just to be on the show. You're just down here, and they're hanging out, and we're having some fun. But Amy and Ben moved up to Northern California last year. Was it last year? It was last year. Okay. Moved up to Northern California last year for several different reasons. One, to be closer to mom and dad. Two, to just be in, live in a beautiful area. And three, to kind of fulfill what has become a deep abiding wish in them, which is to work on and to flip houses, right? Now, today, let me be clear, we're not really focusing on the flipping aspect in the sense of, you know, as if there's a lot of you out there who are looking to get into the, you know, the amateur flipping business. That's not the point. The point is that Amy and Ben have took on an entire house project, bought a house on the market, undervalued home that needed a lot of love and work. And then they poured themselves into it for how many months, guys, now?
10 months
in order to get it ready to sell, and it sold. So congratulations. And it sold for even more than you expected it was going to sell for. So Amy and Ben, they're very, very capable. Amy, okay, just a little background. Here we go. Amy has been a good friend for years and years. She's actually been our hairstylist for years. So she's cut our hair for, I don't know how long, since the beginning of time. Amy is also our chicken whisperer. So Amy helped guide us into, to, you know, our own practice of raising chickens. And I helped Amy with her bees. So it's all a mutual, right? Exactly. So, and Amy does pottery, she does folk art, and she's just, and a few years back with her adding a guest house to her own backyard and remodeling your house here in town, dove in with both hands into like the DIY world and just was stellar with it. Ben is a dear friend. He's a brother from South Carolina, and out here living the good life. And now, is this right? Your official, you worked for a commercial playground company while you were down here, right?
Yeah, yes.
Yeah, okay. Building, you know, those really awesome playgrounds all over town. Ben and I enjoy hanging out together and fishing. We never catch any fish, but we enjoy the fishing. And we enjoy the process. We enjoy thinking about catching fish. Is it fair to say that the two of you kind of fell for each other in the lumber aisle at Home Depot?
The door aisle.
Oh, the door aisle. Sorry. Okay, let me change my notes here. The door aisle. All right. We've got a lot to talk about today. And we're going to dive into that when we return. It is Remodels Gone Right, DIY edition this morning on the show. We're going to find out what the biggest challenges are that they went through, how working together affected their relationship. I mean, they're still together here. Mm-hmm. They're smiling, yeah. So that's a good thing. Even after a remodel, what surprised you? Also, I've got all sorts of questions that I think people would love to know from somebody who's gone through it. Like, ooh, what was that experience like? We're diving into it when we return. I am so glad you joined me this morning. There's so much more to come. You're listening to Home with Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer. Claudette Stefani has the news.
The LA County Health Department says 96% of all recent COVID-19 lab tests are the Delta variant. A five-month-old girl has died in a car crash in Torrance. The girl and her mother were ejected from a car last night. Environmental experts say the heat wave last month was the most extreme summer heat wave ever recorded in North America. We check in on some trouble in downtown next.
So ever since Duffy Power Services became a sponsor here at KFI, I have been getting a ton of questions about how home backup generators work. So here goes. Once Duffy evaluates your home, they hook you up with the perfect generator to meet all of its needs. Then, when the next outage occurs, while everybody else around you loses power and is sitting in the dark, your generator automatically takes over in an instant, and life continues uninterrupted. When the power comes back on, it knows it, and it turns itself off. It's really just that easy. What's also easy about a generator from Duffy is 0% interest financing and payments as low as $72 a month, which makes emergency power totally affordable. So, as you know, the pandemic has everything in short supply. So don't wait. Call Duffy today. Make sure your life, your comfort, your safety is not going to be interrupted during the next outage or any of the ones after that. Dial #250 on your cell and say Duffy Power. #250, Duffy Power, or find Duffy on the web at DuffyPower.com. That's DuthiePower.com.
Southland weather from KFI. Sunny for today. Highs from the upper 60s to mid-70s. At the beaches, upper 70s and 80s inland. Let's check out that trouble in downtown.
It still appears to be blocking the off-ramp there in Diamond Bar on the 60 East of Grand Avenue, but the crash has always closed due to an overturned vehicle and traffic backed up to about Lemon. Santa Ana, good news on the 5017th Street. That's an earlier accident that's cleared from lanes, but you're still a little backed up from the 22. In Orange on the 5 South at Crown Valley Parkway, that's a stalled vehicle in the carpool lane. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Zachary Tagan.
This report is sponsored by Staples Stores. World of Possible. This week, Apple AirPods Pro are only $179, that's $75 off. In-store only, offer ends 7/31, limit 2. Get the tech you need to work and learn from home at Staples Connect, the working and learning store.
Have you wanted to speak a new language but thought it'd be too difficult or take too much time? Then try Babbel. Whether you want to learn Spanish for future travel plans, French to connect with extended family, or maybe German to land a new job, Babbel works because it's built around real life. It teaches you everyday practical conversations that you'll actually use. All you need is 15 minutes a day, and you'll be on your way to confidently speaking a new language in just a few weeks. Babbel is designed by real language experts using a modern conversation-based technique that makes learning fun, engaging, and best of all, memorable. It starts by teaching you words and phrases, then sentences gradually get more complex. Soon you're practicing short conversations about real life topics. And with 14 languages to choose from and lesson topics like travel, business, relationships, and more, you'll be sure to learn what matters most to you. Babbel, language for life. Learn a new language with ease. Go to Babbel.com to try for free. That's B-A-B-B-E-L.com. Babbel.com.
All right, I have a very important question to ask you. Are you planning to sell your home? If you are, it is time to stop thinking nostalgically about it and start thinking about getting the biggest possible return on your investment. That's all that matters at this point. That means it's time to talk to the good people at Revive. You've seen shows that take homes like yours, upgrade them, flip them for a big return. That is the world that Revive comes from, except Revive does for you and your home. Your home is going to net way more profit with just the right upgrades. You don't know what those are. I know you don't. But Revive does. They know exactly how to make the most out of what you've got and even create value where there currently isn't. And the nice thing is, Revive manages everything and fronts all the costs. Yeah, they front the cost. They get paid back from escrow. But the profit gain from what they invest in your home is all yours. The average client makes over 200% profit on what Revive invests on their behalf. This is a no-brainer, my friend. Go to iloverevive.com today and see if your home qualifies. To make the most from the sale of your home, go to iloverevive.com. iloverevive.com.
I struggled with symptoms like frequent gas and stomach pain for years.
I was bloated all the time with daily diarrhea.
At first, I thought it was what I was eating.
I kept thinking it was stomach issues.
So I did my research and talked to my doctor, and we finally uncovered the truth.
It was actually ETI. Exocrine pancreatic insufficiency, or EPI, is a condition where your pancreas is unable to help break down your food.
It can lead to symptoms like diarrhea, gas, bloating, stomach pain, unexplained weight loss, and oily stools.
And EPI symptoms can be confused with those of other common digestive conditions, like irritable bowel syndrome, Crohn's, and celiac disease.
So getting to the right diagnosis meant being more open with my doctor about the severity of my symptoms and how often they were happening.
But there's good news. EPI is manageable, so don't wait any longer. Use the symptom checker at identifyepi.com and schedule a visit or call with your doctor to ask, could I have EPI?
Sponsored by AbbVie.
I just love me a summer vacation, or staycation, or playcation. Tell it whatever you want, and I can do all three right here in Morongo. And now, the top five reasons to visit Morongo. Number five.
Save your cash and pay with points. It's simple. Play, earn, then pay for gas, gifts, and even a room with your rewards points.
Number four.
Mark, Donnie, and Paul are calling you. The coolest brothers bring you the best burgers and fries slathered in Walmart. Now open at Morongo.
Three.
We bring the beach to you at Morongo. Oasis Pool has its own white sand beach.
Number two.
Upgrade your Stage 5 experience. Get illuminating, rejuvenating, or chill mode eye gel for only $20 when you purchase any massage chair.
And the number one reason.
You can't pick just one reason. The slots, the table games, restaurants, bars, Oasis Pool, Stage 5, or the casinos. Pick them all.
Morongo Casino Resort and Spa. Morongo. Good times.
It's okay if you're wondering how the COVID-19 vaccine got here so fast. It was record time, after all. And when you're ready, here's your answer. No steps were skipped. No shortcuts were taken. Years of research and determination paid off. Let's get you there. Let's get to immunity. Learn more at vaccinateall58.com or call 833-422-4255. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
For official rules and more information about contests on this station, go to KFIAM640.com/rules.
Why, hey, how are you today? Wow, wow, and more wow. Tech earnings coming up for some of the biggest companies in technology. And lo and behold, who would have thought that they made a lot of money? Technology is big business, unfortunately. We're the sheep that gets sheared for all that big business, and sometimes it just doesn't work right. Then you call me, your tech guy. Each and every weekend, I'll be here. Leo Laporte, the tech guy. I'll be looking for you.
Leo Laporte, this morning at 11. AMI AM is
more stimulating car.
I'm definitely going to need more coffee this morning. Definitely. I just looked at my cup, and it's empty, and I feel like I've taken two sips. My brain is not like, more coffee! More coffee! KFI, Dean Sharp, the house whisperer, with you this morning. You're listening to Home, where every week we help you better understand that place where you live. Hey, we're talking remodels gone right today. The DIY edition, our first ever DIY edition of Remodels Gone Right. That means that the good folks who are sitting here in the studio with me didn't just decide to remodel a house and hire a general contractor to do it. No, they did it themselves. Amy Carr and Ben Powell, my dear friends, you guys took on a big project. So let's dive in. I have a ton of questions for you. So how big, this was up in Chico, California. And you guys kind of moved up there, part in response to the fires and the fact that Chico has its own housing crisis going on right now. Because I mean, how many homes were destroyed and how many families were displaced?
I want to say somewhere 18,000 structures maybe in Paradise. I'm not sure exact number, but a lot.
A lot.
Yeah.
So there was a need. There's a need for this, and so and a good opportunity for you guys. So. How big was the house? How old was it? And what shape was it in?
It was a little over 1,000 square feet.
Uh-huh.
And 1948.
Okay. And so what shape did you find it in?
Rough.
Is that an official designation? Rough. Okay. So give us a description of rough. I mean, floors, windows, ceiling, you know, what was going on?
Dry rot around all the windows, some dry rot in the hardwood floors, old asbestos linoleum in the bath,
walls covered in
nicotine.
Something.
Covered in something.
It no longer really looked like painted drywall. Let's put it that way. It had a certain patina.
It had a patina.
I do remember around the toilet, you could see light from under the house coming through.
Oh, that's always a nice feature.
It was lovely.
That's always a nice feature, just to sit on the toilet and just have light beaming in from underneath you. So you guys evaluate it and you dove in. You're like, hey, let's do this thing.
It's good bones.
Yeah. So you felt like it had good bones.
We did, and we,
you know, again, you just look at it and decide what you think the possibilities are, and we felt like we could accomplish what we needed to do without having to really change the whole structure of the house. In other words, like add on to it. That we could use the footprint of the house and create what we really wanted. Right, and so that's an important thing when you're thinking about a remodel, whether you're evaluating, like, how much of the bones are we actually changing, or is a lot of this, I don't want to say superficial in the sense that, I mean, this house was a lot more than just going in and repainting, clearly, okay?
Sure, yes.
But pouring new concrete, doing an addition, that's a whole nother ball game apart from reworking inside the envelope of the house.
Exactly.
Yep. So what did you guys plan in terms of how much money you were going to put into it and how long it was going to take?
We originally planned to put $35,000 into it, and we doubled that. We originally planned to work on it for 4 to 5 months, and we doubled that.
Okay. So 35 went to like 70, mm-hmm. and 4 to 5 months went to
10 months. Actually 9-10 with escrow.
Was that out of utter necessity? Was this like on TV when you got into it and you're like, oh no, we have this now to tackle. We didn't see this before. Or as you, because there's two ways I've noticed that folks, actually three. The first way, I know you guys didn't do, the first thing that increases schedules and budgets is when people just don't really spend enough time planning and evaluating things up front. They're just like, yeah, well, oh yeah, they'll be fine. And you get in and, you know, having not thought things through, you find out you're in a totally different situation. Big surprise there. I know you guys didn't do that. The other two ways is, number one, you really do, kind of like on the drama on HGTV shows, you really do end up finding stuff that you weren't anticipating, and that really throws a wrench in the works. Or it's a combination of that, and maybe once you're in it, you find you're a little more emotionally invested in bringing it up to a certain level, and you're like, you know what, we were talking yesterday, you're like, do we really need to cloth all those moldings? Could we sell this thing, you know, have the realtor kind of move people through quicker and just, you know. And you guys just, I think you also made some decisions to just invest a little more quality into the process.
Definitely.
So both were true? I mean,
I would say, well, the one major thing we discovered that we hadn't planned on was rebracing the floor joists. So that meant we had to tear up all the subfloor, and not under the hardwood, but under the back half of the house, where we wanted to put tiles, so that added a good couple of weeks that we hadn't anticipated, and money in lumber. A lot of the cost came from the price of lumber going up during our project. Towards the end, we started spending more and more and more.
Well, because you did this during COVID.
Exactly.
And then, as we've talked about so many times. All right, so when we come back, we'll talk about those floors and some of the other challenges that you guys encountered along the way. And I think this is going to be very helpful for people who are considering this on their own. You are home with Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer, Claudette Stefani.
A 5-month-old girl has died in a crash in Torrance. The girl and her mother were ejected from a car last night. The crash happened around 5 when one of the cars was making a left turn. Police say the girl and her mother were passengers in the backseat of the car making the left turn. The CDC says the coronavirus is continuing to live through people who are not vaccinated. CDC Director Dr. Rochelle Walensky says she understands why some people are scared.
This is not unlike other things that are mandated, other vaccines that are mandated for school-going children, for healthcare personnel. I'm mandated every year as I work in the hospital to get a flu vaccine.
She says she is all for more vaccinations, but she says it's up to the White House to figure out if and how a national mandate would be put in place. Amazon has announced that it employs more than 900,000 people in the U.S. It's the first time the company has said publicly how many workers it has. The number doesn't include Amazon Prime drivers. Amazon is the second largest employer in the U.S. Walmart is number one. Let's check in on some traffic. We've got trouble over in West Covina.
It's a work zone on the 10 West from Citrus to Vincent Avenue. The 3 left lanes are closed for about another hour and a half. In Diamond Bar on the 60 East of Grand Avenue, that's a crash that's all lanes closed due to an overturned vehicle. The traffic's backed up to about Lemon. Costa Mesa 405 South from Fairview Road on Highway 73, that's a full lane closure until 8 a.m. for bridge work. And then Orange 5 South at Crown Valley Parkway, that's a stalled vehicle in the carpool lane. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Zachary Kagan.
So, you're ready to build your new dream kitchen. Congratulations. What is going to be your first move? I'm going to say it should be a totally free consult in the showroom with my friends at the kitchen store. It means you get two things right off the bat. You get the creativity and the wisdom of an expert kitchen designer, and you need that when it comes to your kitchen. And you're going to get that while you're being flooded with inspiration at the kitchen store's 7,000 square foot cabinet design showroom. There's nothing like it in Southern California. The kitchen store is right off the 405 in Culver City. For more than 50 years, it is the place for kitchen cabinets in all of Southern California. State-of-the-art computer design, 12-month stainless cash financing, pricing that beats the big box centers. So, start your new kitchen right. Set up your free consult by dialing 310-KITCHEN. That's 310-KITCHEN. And check out the kitchen store on the web at 310kitchen.com.
South Land weather from KFI, sunny for today. Highs from the upper 60s to mid-70s at the beaches, upper 70s and 80s inland. Highs in the 80s and 90s for the valleys. Highs from 82 to 87 in the inland OC. Highs from 94 to 100 in the IE. And then expect low temperatures to drop into the 60s by this evening. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Claudette Stefani.
When it comes to your identity and keeping it safe, the folks at LifeLock want to make sure that your information stays secure. So let's say during the pandemic, or even now, you're working overtime, you're saving your money, you're paying off your debt, and now some identity thief wants to steal your information. This is why LifeLock by Norton helps monitor your information and alerts you to potential identity threats. And if you do become a victim, a dedicated USA specialist will be there to help fix it. Now, no one can prevent all identity theft or monitor every transaction, every business. But when identity thieves try to take what's yours, you don't have to take it lying down because there's LifeLock. Save up to 25% off your first year. Call 800-LIFELOCK or go to LifeLock.com, promo code handle. That's LifeLock.com, promo code handle. Or call 800-LIFELOCK, promo code handle. Once again, that's promo code handle for 25% off at LifeLock.com.
Hi, Don. I'm a helpful Southern California Honda person, and I'm calling to give you a random act of helpfulness.
Wow!
We heard you'd like help getting something for a veterans organization.
I work for the nonprofit. Mm-hmm. Homeless veterans are referred to us. We help them to get back into society and to get into permanent housing. Oh. Barbecuing is something they love to do as a group, so I've been trying to get them one, but there are no extra funds for those types of things.
Well, Honda would like to help. We're going to get them that grill.
Oh, my God, I'm going to cry. Well, I'm just so excited. I've got shakes and chills.
Today we help some veterans, and we can help you too. Right now you can get 0% APR financing on an award-winning Honda SUV, like the 2021 Pilot. Visit SoCalHondaDealers.com to find a helpful Honda dealer near you. For well-qualified buyers on approved credit through Honda Financial Services. Don is a real person and must pay to be on the radio.
Why? KFI AM 640.
Local.
Our radio station.
KFI AM 640. Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. You are home.
The Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer.
Gonna warm up today.
You are wise. You are wise for being up this early because, you know, just like Tina and I experience on a daily basis, and this is not me. It is me. I'm gonna preach the early rising gospel. No matter how hot and crazy Southern California summers get, if you are an early riser, guess what? You get to experience cool weather every single day because the mornings are gorgeous. They're beautiful. And this coffee is delicious. And thank you very much for refilling my cup. Let's all just take a moment and enjoy this cup of coffee, shall we? Here we go.
All right. It is Remodels Gone Right today. DIY edition. Our first ever DIY edition. So my in-studio guests, Amy Carr and Ben Powell, have just accomplished a major remodel on a house up in Northern California. And they did it with their own hands. And that is why it's such a unique edition of Remodels Gone Right. So it's about a 1,000-square-foot house. Older home. 40s, did you say?
48.
48. In not great shape, clearly. And that was the whole point. That was your goal anyway, right?
Yeah.
And some unexpected things, COVID, a pandemic. I don't know why you guys didn't plan for a pandemic. You should always plan for a pandemic to happen.
Of course.
Supply issues, cost of lumber went up on you right through the whole thing. This is what, by the way, if there's ever an argument for keeping costs down by doing things yourself, it's when unexpected costs are incurred because even though your budget increased significantly, you could only imagine how much more you would be paying if you had a general contractor and fees and all of these other things happening instead of you guys doing it yourself. So yes, the budget went up, but you kept it as low as it theoretically could have been.
Correct.
Along the way. And it ended up taking me twice as long, but, you know, pandemic, you had plenty of time on your hands. So, you know, in lockdown, it's a good time to be working on your house, because what else are you going to do today? What were some of the biggest challenges, as you guys remember? I mean, the things that you thought, ooh, wow, have we bit off more than we can chew with this?
What would you say? I know what you said that.
I just think a little bit of the unexpected. You know, you go in, you look at it, you create some vision in your head of what it could be. And, but the main thing I think was the floor in the back.
I would say also the yard. We didn't give enough attention to the yard in the very beginning, and wow, that can add up real quick with tree removal, and then you realize roots and removal of vines that are still in the ground.
How big a piece of property was it? Is it
6,500 square feet?
All right, so not a big lot.
No.
Not a big lot, but it was fairly overgrown and neglected.
Yeah.
So we're talking about price per square footage cost. Working outside is not a very high price per square foot cost. It's actually low, but 6,500 square feet of even a low price out there adds up fast and sucks up a lot of time.
It's the time, yeah.
So you guys spent more time outside, wrestling with outside than you initially anticipated.
Yeah, definitely agree with that, yeah.
What about those moments of frustration? Just give us a peek into one of them. Give me a good one. Do you have to think about that? Should I warm you up? Should I ask you that one later, or do you have one on the tip of your tongue?
No, I would say a lot of our frustration just came from communication, really. Having never worked on a project every single day together. First of all, we live together too. Tell everybody that. So you add that to the
being day to day together, and now the communication, it was a lot of learning how each other thinks and when a good time to bring something up, and then also waiting, having to wait. I'm very impatient, so there's a lot of frustration that came from, I want to do this now, and he's busy doing something else, and I really can't approach him in that mood, so I need to wait and be patient, and that was very hard for me. But I learned from it, and I think going forward we'll be better at that, and I'm sure I was not easy to work with all the time as well.
Yeah, me either. But I would totally agree. I think the one thing that came from the process and the experience is that we learned, you know, a lot about each other, and especially, you know, being a couple already, I just feel like we've learned how to communicate with each other better, and I think that can only serve us, you know, better in our relationship and as we move forward, because this is what we want to do, you know, find more homes and renovate them and resell them. So that process, I think, even though maybe difficult in the moment, good in the long run.
Right.
Yeah. Right. Okay, so you bring up a really important point, something that I personally think kind of shepherded so many clients through this process. If there is one thing, if you were going to ask me, what's the one thing that most people think about the least when it comes to remodeling their home, I would say there are two elements, but they both come from the same root. It's number one, how well do you guys work together? Because this is a stressful situation, right? We're talking about your number one, now you guys were, this was a home that you were using as a business, but homes are, for the vast majority of folks, their largest, number one, most significant investment. There's a lot emotionally run, on the line to do it. And your relationship together, how you work together, have you thought that through? Because when we start thinking about remodeling the house, we're so focused on the house. It's the house. It's the house. It's the house. Well, guess what? Guess who's doing the house? This relationship is doing the house. And so a lot about how that house turns out is, and unfortunately, I have seen relationships not survive remodels. It's not the remodel's fault. It's not anybody's fault, but going in, you know, open-eyed and aware of just like, are we really, is this, and even if we have a good relationship, the question is, with everything that's going on right now, is this really the right time to do this, right? Evaluating whether this is the right moment in the relationship to take